can grasp your infinite wisdom? Who can fathom the depths of your love? You are beautiful beyond description, majesty enthroned above. And I stand in awe of you. I stand in awe of you. Holy God, to whom all praise is due, I stand in awe of you.
He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in Him will I trust. Surely He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with His feathers, and under His wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thine eyes thou shalt behold and see the reward of the wicked. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, I greet each one of you in the wonderful and precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We praise God for this wonderful privilege the Lord has given to us to worship the name of the Lord. The Lord has allowed us to come thus far and to worship His name. I also welcome all the brothers and sisters outside of Bhubaneswar, those who have joined us in this online worship service. We welcome you. Let us together worship the name of the Lord and let us praise His name. Our God is an amazing God and His grace is amazing. So this morning, let us begin our worship service by singing an old hymn, Amazing Grace, How Sweet the Sound. Let's sing this hymn and worship the Lord.
Saved a wretch like me.
Let us pray. Let every eyes be closed and every head be bowed before the Lord. And this morning we are in the presence of God. Never forget that the Lord is with us. The Almighty God, His presence is with us. And this morning as we are worshiping, let us feel His presence. The Almighty God is ready to be worshipped. And this morning let us worship the Lord. Let's pray. Gracious God, our loving Father, we come to your throne of grace in the name of Jesus Christ, our blessed Lord, by the help of the Holy Spirit. Lord, we lift the name of Jesus, our blessed Lord, who died for us on the cross of Calvary and who gave his life on the cross, who shed his precious blood on the cross. By his blood we are redeemed. Our sins are washed away. And Lord, we are your people. You have chosen us before the foundation of the earth, and you have sanctified us. And Lord, you have given us this wonderful privilege to serve you, to worship you, and to magnify your name. Lord God of heaven, this morning we remember all your goodness in our life. We remember all your blessings in our life, O Lord. What a wonderful God we serve. What a good God we serve. Every day your mercy is new, O Lord. Every morning we experience in a new way the mercy of the Lord, the grace of the Lord in our life, in our individual life and in our family life and in our church life, O Lord. What a wonderful God, what a almighty God we serve. Father, we thank you for this wonderful privilege to serve you and to lift the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Lord, blessed be the name of the Lord. We want to thank you, Lord. We want to thank you and praise your name, because you are a good God. You are a wonderful God. You are a holy God. We serve a holy God, and we serve a living God who has conquered sin and death, who has conquered Satan. And today we are your people, O Lord. This morning we bow down before you, Lord. We humbly bow down before you, Lord. And we want to thank you. We want to praise your name. We want to bless your name, O Lord. Heavenly Father, this morning as we begin this worship service, O Lord, Lord, we pray, Spirit of God, you empower us, O Lord. And Lord, help us to worship you in spirit and in truth, so that our worship may be acceptable in your sight, O Lord. Lord, we want to see the name of Jesus Christ is highly exalted and lifted up. This morning, Lord, we worship you. Thank you, God, for listening to our prayer. Lord, we commit this worship service into your mighty hand. Lord, you lead us and guide us by your Holy Spirit. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. We serve a wonderful God. And this morning, for our meditation this morning, the scripture portion is taken from Judges chapter 6, verse 13. I am reading from King James Version. You may follow your own version. The word of God read like this. And Gideon said unto him, O my Lord, if the Lord be with us, why then is all this befallen us? And where be all his miracle, which our fathers told us of, saying, did not the Lord bring us up from Egypt? But now the Lord has forsaken us and delivered us into the hands of the Midianites. May the good Lord add his rich blessing upon the reading and understanding of his holy word. We shall continue to worship God, and let us sing another hymn. The title of the hymn is, Hide Me Now Under Your Wings, Cover Me Within Your Mighty Hand. As we sing this hymn, we shall bring our tithe and offering to the house of the Lord, And those who are sending your offerings and tithe on online, you may kindly do so. And those who are not able to give your tithe and offering on online, you can set apart the offering and tithe. And Monday, Wednesday and Friday, our church treasurer, Mr. Punnanda Pradhan, our deacon, Mr. Santanu Kumar Rao, our deacon, Mr. Michael Rajesh Behra, and our deacon, Mr. Sandeep Kumar, they will be available in the church campus morning 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. So you can bring your offering and tithe to them and give to them and collect your receipt. Let me remind you again, our church treasurer and the deacons, our leaders, they will be available in the church campuses on Monday, Wednesday and Friday. So you can bring your offering to them.
The flood. I will
Let's pray. But before prayer, let me give you some information. Those who are willing to receive the prayer from the church, and if you like to the church to pray for your special days like birthday or marriage anniversary or any special occasion, you may give your name on Wednesday by 12 o'clock. Your name to Reverend Sangram Kesari Singh, and his WhatsApp number is 94372844 15. You may contact him and give your names so that we can add your name in the prayer list. This coming days, our brothers and sisters, those who are going to celebrate their birthday and also the marriage anniversary, we will uphold them in our prayer. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for this wonderful privilege to come to your throne of grace in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord, and we believe that you are a prayer answering God. You always listen to the prayer of your people. Father, this morning we want to thank you for Sister Soumya Subhadarshini Dukhu as she is celebrating her birthday. Lord, we pray, Lord, you bless our dear sister and be with her in this new day. And Lord, let your grace and mercy be upon her, O Lord. Father, we also thank you for our Joint Secretary, Dr. Happybon Naik, and Sister Sasi Prabha Naik, as they are celebrating their marriage anniversary. 32 years they have lived together as husband and wife. We thank you, Lord, for joining together, and we thank you, Lord, for their family life. We have blessed them, O Lord. And this morning, O Lord, we remember our dear brother and sister into your hand, O Lord. Lord, you bless them, and Lord, you use them continually, use them for your glory, O Lord. Lord, this morning we also pray for our dear brothers and sisters, those who need your healing touch in their body. Lord, this morning we pray for our dear sister Jyotsna Naik, the wife of our brother Ranjan Naik, O Lord. Lord, we pray, O Lord, for our dear sister. You touch her, O Lord, and Lord, you heal her completely. Father, this morning we also remember our dear sister Olaka Pradhan, O Lord, as she need your healing touch in her body, O Lord. We pray, Lord, you touch her and heal her completely. Heavenly Father, this morning we also remember our dear sister Minerva Raut, O Lord. We pray, O Lord, you touch our dear sister, O Lord, and heal her completely. O Father, this morning we pray for our dear brother Hirakumar Pramanik, and Lord, you touch your servant, O God, and heal him, O Lord. Father, this morning we also pray for the buried family of our church, brother Arkesh Shaw and his family. Lord, we pray, Lord, Lord, you comfort them and console them. We also remember the family of Dr. Ashish Lal Ji Jachok. Oh Lord, as you have taken your servant to your heavenly abode, we remember the family at Sambalpur, O Lord. Lord, you be with them, and Lord, you console them, and Lord, you give them your peace and joy, O God. Heavenly Father, this morning we thank you for your presence is with us, and we pray for all the brothers and sisters, O Lord. You bless them and touch them, O Father. Lord, this morning we pray for the families of Union Church, all the brothers and sisters of Union Church, O Lord. You bless each one of them, O Father. We also pray for all the parents and all the children and all the young people of our church. Lord, we also pray for the Church of Odisha, O Lord, wherever they are, O Lord. Lord, those who are joining with us in this worship service, O Lord, we pray, God, Lord, you bless them, O Father. Lord, you revive the churches of Odisha that we may experience the power of the Holy Spirit in our individual, in our church life, O Lord. Heavenly Father, this morning we also pray for our country, O Lord, the great country, India, O Lord. We pray, O Lord, you bless our country, O Lord. You remove every of our problems, O Lord. Every of our plagues from our country, O Lord. Lord, as our country is fighting against the COVID-19, O Lord, we pray this morning, O Lord, we pray for the doctors and nurses, and we pray for the health workers, O Lord, those who are engaged in this eradicating this coronavirus, O Lord. We pray, O Lord, you bless each one of them and protect them, O Father. Lord, it is you, only you can heal our nation, O Lord, because your word says, if my people humble themselves and turn from their wickedness, wickedness. Oh Lord, you said in your word, you will hear their prayer and you will heal their land, O Lord. This morning we confess our sin before you, Lord. We as a church, O Lord, we have failed, O Lord. Oh Lord, we pray this morning, O God, we humble heart. And Lord, we pray, Lord, you visit our nation, O Lord. You visit our people, O Lord. Lord, you heal our people, O Lord. Our land needs your healing touch, O Lord. Oh Lord, we need your healing in our spiritual life, O Lord. We need your healing in our body, O Lord. We need your healing in our mental life, O Lord. Oh Lord, in our emotional life, O Father. Father, this morning we commit our great nation, India, into your mighty hand. Lord, you bless our nation. Father, we thank you for listening to our prayer. This morning, O Lord, as we are preparing our hearts to meditate your word, O Lord. Father, this morning we pray for your servant, Reverend Sandeep Giri, as he ministered to us. We pray, O Lord, you anoint your servant with the Holy Spirit and speak through him, O Lord, that we may listen to your voice. Father, we thank you for all the good gifts that you have given to us. We thank you for the offering that has been collected. Lord, you bless it and use it for the glory of God. And thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for listening to our prayer. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. Now we have come to the most important part of our worship service. This morning we are very happy to have our youth and mission pastor, Reverend Sandeep Giri. He's a young man who has a zeal and enthusiasm to reach out to the people. And this morning, it is our privilege to have him. Now, may I call upon God's servant, Reverend Sandeep Kumar Giri, to come forward and minister to us what the Lord has laid in his heart this morning. Reverend Sandeep Giri.
Good morning to all. I greet you all in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Indeed, God is good, and we all can feel in this lockdown time that God is good. The scripture portion of today's meditation I have taken from Judges chapter 6 verse 13. In this lockdown time, Lord has spoke to me, and I know all of you able to heard that voice of God. Lord taught me three things which I want to share with you today. First, this lockdown time showing us the limitations of human being and nations. And this lockdown time, it is showing us the sovereignty of Lord. And this lockdown time, it is also taught us that what is the roles and responsibility of individual and our church. Let us pray before we dip down in the lessons from Gideon's life. Mighty Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for this wonderful time. Yes, Lord, we know that you are a good God. Everything has a purpose of yours, and we are feeling those things in our life. Though this lockdown time is a difficult time for all of us, but we know you are with us. We know you are with us to sustain us. You are with us to deliver us. You are with us to guide us. You are with us to lift up us. Thank you, Lord, for your concern, for your present, for your all good things you have given in our life. As we are going to meditate over your word, Holy Spirit, Lord, you speak with each one of us. You speak the truth, the eternal truth, through which we can able to live in this world according to your will. Hide me, Lord. You speak to your people. Thank you for hearing our prayer, because I pray in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. So today, I would like to share six numbers eternal truth with you. And I request you to keep in your heart so that you will never be discouraged, because these lessons helped me a lot. So as I have read the scripture person from Judges chapter 6 verse 13, we can see a person who was an ordinary person like you and me. And his name was Gideon. He was a regular guy and he was not a very impressive man like you and me. But he made some choices in his life. And we can see clearly how God used him for his glory. So this morning, we will focus our Gideon's life. And we can learn six lessons. First is, God uses tough times to get our attention. God uses tough times to get our attention. As we open chapter 6 of Judges, we can see it is written in verse 1, again the Israelites did evil in the eyes of the Lord. And if you will go ahead, go before that verse in chapter 5 verse 31, it is written, so may all your enemies perish, O Lord, but may they who love you be like the sun when it rises in its strength, then the land had peace 40 years. It is written here that the land had peace for 40 years. That means that time we find a nation of Israel coming off a time of relative ease. What is the meaning of that? They had a good time. They had an excellent time. Their business was good. Their kids were behaving very good. Their all bills were paid off in right time. Everything coming up roses. Means they are sprouting, they are growing in all of their perspective. But when chapter 6 verse 1 started, we can see clearly it is written, again the Israelites did evil in the eyes of the Lord. Verse 1 says that the Israelites did what was evil in the sight of the Lord. Then as we read verse 2, verse 3, it is written there, so the Lord handed them over to Midian for 7 years. Who were that Midians? Midianites were descendants of Midian, means Abraham and Keturah. And it is written about Amalekites. Amalekites were descendants of Esau. So, Lord handed them over to Midian for 7 years. Why it was happened? Because the Israelites did evil in the eyes of the Lord. You need to know that the Midianites were extremely powerful and oppressed the Israelites mercilessly. As it is written here, in verse 3, whenever the Israelites planted their crops, the Midianites, Amalekites and other eastern peoples invaded the country. They camped on the land and ruined the crops all the way to Gaza and did not spare a living thing for Israel, neither sheep nor cattle nor donkeys. They came up with their livestock and their tents like swarms of locusts. It was impossible to count the men and their camels. They invaded the land to ravage it. Midian so impoverished the Israelites that they cried out to the Lord for help. One question arose in my mind when I was meditating this verse. Why did Israelites wait so long to respond to God? Because they are just like you and me. They waited until every possible option played out and they had. They waited for 7 years. They waited for 7 years to return back to God, to cry out to God. In Proverbs 3, chapter 3, verse 11 and 12, it is written, do not despise the Lord's instruction, my son, and do not loathe his discipline. For the Lord disciplines the one he loves, just as a father, the son he delights in. He loves you too much to let you keep living the way you are. So crisis comes in our life, in your life and in my life, in the life of our nations. But when it comes, instead of looking at them, we should look to God. Hallelujah. We should look to the Lord. Why? Because in crisis time, in difficulties time, God draws our attention towards Him. So C.S. Lewis said like this: God whispers to us in our pleasures, speaks in our conscience, but shouts in our pains. So crisis time is Lord's megaphone to rouse a deaf world. I want to read again this thing. God whispers to us in our pleasures, speaks in our conscience, but shouts in our pains. And so, crisis time is megaphone to rouse a deaf world. So, my dear God's children, always crisis time draws the attentions towards God. Second point, God sees more than we do. God sees more than we do. The wonderful thing about God is that even we are slow returning to Him, He responds quickly. And we cannot see, we cannot comprehend how God looks a person. Clearly in verse 13, it is written, Gideon replied, "If the Lord is with us, why has all this happened to us? Where are all His wonders that our fathers told us about when they said, 'Did not the Lord bring us up out of Egypt?'" Before that, if we will see about Gideon, Gideon was inside the wine press. He was threshing the wheat inside the wine press. And we can see a fearful man there. But in verse 11, one angel of the Lord came and sat down under the oak in Ophrah that belonged to Joash the Abiezrite, where his son Gideon was threshing wheat in a wine press to keep it from the Midianites. You can see a fearful man over there. But the angel of the Lord appeared to Gideon and saying, look at to that point, "The Lord is with you, mighty warrior." Was God being sarcastic? What do you think? Was God being sarcastic? Was God joking to Gideon? Because we can see clearly a fearful man threshing the wheat by hiding inside the wine press to Midianites, and that time angel is coming and clearly saying, "The Lord is with you, mighty warrior." Brothers and sisters, do you know who you are really? In John chapter 1 verse 12, it is written, "You are God's child." In John chapter 15 verse 15, it is written, "You are His friend." And Ephesians 2 verse 10, it is written, "We are His masterpiece." And Romans 5 1, it is written, "We have been justified." And Romans 8 1, it is written, "We are freed forever from condemnation from God." And Ephesians 1 5, it is written, "We are adopted into His family." So who you are really? In world's eye, with other people's eye, we may be a coward. We may be a fearful man. We may be an ordinary man. But God is saying, if God is with us, then we are mighty warrior. Hallelujah. Third point, God confirms His priorities with His presence. God confirms His priorities with His presence. After being called a mighty warrior, Gideon replied, as written in verse 13, "If the Lord is with us, why has all this happened to us? If the Lord is with us, then why it is happening to us?" But God turned to him. He looked Gideon full in the face and said, "Go in the strength you have and deliver Israel from the power of Midian. Am I not sending you? Am I not sending you? In verse 14, Lord turned to him and said, go in the strength you have and save Israel out of Midian's hand. Am I not sending you? Who you are? Who am I? We are all fearful men in this critical situation. Most of us have afraid of that coronavirus or that situation. But we always need to remember one thing. We are not alone. God is saying the same thing. Am I not sending you? Am I not with you? So God confirms his priorities with his presence. In verse 16, the Lord answered, I will be with you, and you will strike down all the Midianites together. Midianites were powerful, vigorous enemy. But God is saying, I will be with you. I will be with you, and you will strike down all the Midianites together. So God confirms his priorities with his presence. So Gideon was ready now by hearing this thing from God. But one peculiar thing we can see in Gideon's life, that fourth point is private faithfulness is a prerequisite to public usefulness. Private faithfulness is a prerequisite to public usefulness. Before Gideon can be used in publicly, he must first clean up his own backyard. And we can see clearly here, Gideon went in verse 19 you can see, prepared a young goat, and from an ephah of flour he made bread without yeast, putting the meat in a basket and its broth in a pot. He brought them out and offered them to him under the oak. Then in verse 25 it is written, that same night the Lord said to him, take the second bull from your father's herd, the one 7 years old, tear down your father's altar to Baal and cut down the Asherah pole beside it. Then build a proper kind of altar to the Lord your God on the top of this height. Using the wood of the Asherah pole that you cut down, offer the second bull as a burnt offering. So Gideon took 10 of his servants and did as the Lord told him. But because he was afraid of his family and the men of the town, he did it at night rather than in the daytime. Gideon did the right thing. Though he was very much afraid of his family and the town people, but he did the right thing. He eradicated all the unnecessary idols from his household. As per God's instruction. So, if you want to learn how to trust God, you must first set your own house in order. And why did Gideon threshing the wheat inside the wine press when there was also a lockdown time that didn't time, then why did he was doing this thing? We can see clearly he has a role and responsibility for his house, just like you and me. So Gideon was threshing the wheat inside the wine press. He was hiding to Midianites, but in his heart, he has a responsibility and roles for his family. So, private faithfulness is a prerequisite to public usefulness. And fifthly, we can see God is patientful with our faith process. In verse 33 to 40, when you can see, Gideon said to God, if you will save Israel by my hand as you have promised, look, I will place a wool fleece on the threshing floor. If there is dew only on the fleece and all the ground is dry, then I will know that you will save Israel by my hand, as you said. So Gideon wants some signs from God to believe, to trust on him. Many times we are acting like this only. Though we used to tell that we are faithful, we have faith towards God, but we are very slow in our faith process. And that time, God is not angry over us. God is waiting on us very patiently. Gideon says to Lord, if you will deliver Israel by my hand, I will put a fleece of wool on the threshing floor and you make wet that fleece over that ground. And God will show you the same patience as well as you seek his face. As Gideon seek his face, though he was very slow in his faith process, but Gideon get that sign in right time. Gideon got that sign in right time. When he allowing his fears to grow into a man after God's own heart, God wait patiently with his faith process. So that same thing definitely happened to us also. And sixthly, last point is, success is determined by God's power. Success is determined by God's power. Success never belongs to us. In chapter 7, verse 1 to 8, when you read in your house, you can see how Gideon defeated the Midianites only with 300 people. God created an impossible situation of human weakness to exalt his own strength. Please open with me Zechariah chapter 4, verse 6. Zechariah chapter 4, verse 6. And it is written here, so he said to me, this is the word of the Lord to Zerubbabel, not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord Almighty. What is impossible with man, it is possible with God. And here is a good lesson for us. Accomplishing God's purpose is not determined by the bottom line of a finance sheet or the size of strength we have, but it determines by God's strength. In Zechariah 6, it is clearly written that not by might nor by power, but by my spirit. My dear God's children, it happened in Israel. It happened in Israel before so many years. And we can see the success comes from God. And it also happened in our life. So I want to repeat that 6 points. God uses tough times to get our attention. Is he getting your attention today? God always sees more than we do. Do you see yourself as God do? God confirms his priorities with his presence. Can you sense his presence? Can you sense his priorities? And private faithfulness is a prerequisite to public usefulness. Are there things in your life which are distracting you from God's work? Which are distracting you from your faithfulness in your home, in your private life, in your workplace, that need to go so God can move in power in your life? God is patientful with your faith process. He meets you right where you are. So keep faith on God. And success is determined by God's power, not ours. Will you trust him today? With your life, with your children, with your finances, your decision, your all things. Let us pray. Mighty Heavenly Father, thank you for talking with us, Lord, today. Lord, we are fearful men like Gideon. But we know that you are the same God who was with Gideon, and you are with us. Lord, help us to be with you still our last breath. In Jesus' name we ask. Amen. Thank you. God bless you.
I believe the Lord has spoken to us this morning. Let us respond to God's word and let us commit our life to the Lord. Let's pray. Father, we We are grateful to you and thankful to you for speaking to our hearts this morning through your servant. Lord, have you help us so that we can understand your word, O Lord. And Lord, that we may live for you and that we may overcome any obstacle that we face these days, O Lord. Lord, we thank you for your servant. Continually bless him and bless his family. Lord, this morning I especially pray for his wife, Sister Shelley, O Lord. You touch her and heal her completely so that your servant can move around and he can share the gospel of Jesus Christ to the people. Lord, bless his family and bless his ministry. Thank you, Lord, for listening to our prayer. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. Let us receive the benediction. Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God the Father and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us now and forever and ever. Amen. Thank you. God bless you. Thank you for joining with us in this online worship service. Tomorrow, Monday, we have a prayer meeting at 7 o'clock. Please join with us in the Monday prayer meeting, and I believe the Lord is going to bless us. Thank you so much.